How to share screen on Zoom for Mac. In this tutorial video, I will show you how to share the screen on Zoom for Mac. For you to share a screen on Mac or MacBook, you will need to join a meeting and have permission from the host. When you are in a meeting, please click on the Share Screen button. You have here lots of options. But first, click on one of these if you see the desktop and other option with this symbol. I will click on desktop one as I have two monitors. On this pop-up, click on Open System Preferences. On Security and Privacy window, if this checkbox is unclickable, please be sure to click the lock from the bottom of the window. Here, you can click on Later, as this will work like so. Go back to Zoom for MacBook and click again on Share Screen. On top of this window, we have three options: Basic, Advanced, and Files. Let's explain a bit every option. The desktop option is simply the share of the screen. You will see all of the info from your current screen. Because I have two screens, I see desktop 1 and desktop 2. When you share a whiteboard, you will get a whiteboard table that you can write and draw. This is very useful if you are a teacher that wants to share a whiteboard on Zoom for Mac. Another option on the Basic tab is iPhone iPad. You can use this option if you wish to share the screen from your iPad or iPhone. You will be able to connect your phone to the Wi-Fi and share directly on the PC your screen. Also, it is essential to notice two options: Share computer sound and optimize screen sharing for video clips. I always use these two options. The first option will allow other people to hear what I hear on the computer. So if I play a video, if this option is not checked, the participants will not hear the sound. The other option will make so the participants will see almost in real time what I do on the screen. Let's click on Advanced to talk about this option. If you select the share portion of the screen, then you will be able to screen share only a part of the screen. This will give you the possibility to use the other part of the screen for preparing the data. You can also share music or computer sound only. And if you have multiple cameras on your computer, even content from your second camera. Let's tap on the Files tab. We can share files from different cloud providers. I now have only three providers: Microsoft, Google, and Box. Let's share the desktop screen for Mac. Select desktop 1 and click Share. Because I have selected the option to share computer sound, I will need to install Zoom Audio device. So write your password and click OK. Now I am sharing the screen of my desktop in Zoom for Mac. We have some interesting options here. Let's go to a website on Safari to show you an excellent option. If you go with the cursor on the bar from the top, we have the option Annotate. Click it. You can write, draw, add text, or spotlight some parts of the desktop directly for the person who are watching. This is extremely nice. If you finish playing with this option, you could clear them real easy. If you activate annotation, please go to the More option and disable Attendee Annotation. Or, if you wish to allow other users to do annotation, you can click on Show Names of Annotators, and you will be able to see who made any annotation. This option is also available for the whiteboard. Let's try to screen share a whiteboard for now. You will see here lots of options. First thing that you need to know, if you do not wish somebody else to use the whiteboard, do the same as we did on Share the Desktop screen. Disable annotation to be sure you are the only one who writes on the whiteboard. Also, you have a great option on remote control. You can give control of your mouse to somebody to write on the whiteboard. If you are a teacher and you wish somebody to write, you can set up that. The rest of the options are pretty basics: text, draw, spotlight, format. But they are what you need. My advice is to try to test it yourself so you will be able to use it without any problems. I advise you to create a meeting for yourself and play around with all of these settings to understand how they work. I will mention the option to save and clear. The clear option will allow you to delete any drawings that are not yours, or just your drawings, or all drawings. Also, the save option will allow you to keep what you worked on this whiteboard. Now let's stop sharing the whiteboard. When you have multiple windows open on MacBook, Zoom can share only a software. I have on my PC a Safari opened window. If I select this, then all other windows will not be visible to others. So this is very useful if you do not wish to show what you do on your computer. Let's say we have a presentation and we wish to show only the Excel software, not other stuff on the computer. We select this and click Share. What we do on the rest of the computer, even if it's on the same screen, it will not be seen by others. If I try to do something else on the PC, the sharing option will be paused, and others will not see anything that I do. Now, let's try an advanced option, portion of the screen. The green border part is the one part you share with your viewers. You can resize this quite easily by going with the mouse over and click and drag. When the border is orange, then it means the sharing is paused. Let's do a quick test. This is the only part of the screen that the other participants see. My opinion is that if you are a teacher or if you wish to do a professional presentation, use Zoom for Mac. This is by far the most advanced version of Zoom and also has options that on other devices do not work. If this was useful, please like, share and subscribe. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them in the comments area below.